Hello and greetings, everyone. I've got a story for you now, but it's quite a long story, so I'll just try and simplify you just a little bit. Baldar was the son of Odin and son of Frigga, and he was the most well-loved person in all of Asgard. Everyone loved him. Every woman, every man, every child, every tree, every stone, every living creature all loved Baldar. He was the perfect god. Kind, generous, handsome. He was the golden boy of the gods. If Odin never decided not to lead the gods, Baldar would take his place. Baldar would have been everyone's perfect god. Now then, Baldar was having a lot of bad dreams. And he went to Frigga. He says, "Frigga, I'm having bad dreams." And she goes, "What's your dreams?" He says, "I'm going to be murdered." She goes, "Nothing would murder you." He says, "I'm going to be murdered within the next few days." And she goes, no. She says, "I'll put a stop to that." So she went out and made all the gods give the oath they weren't going to hurt Baldar. All the gods give the oath. Then she went to all the trolls. All the trolls give the oath. All the dwarfs give the oath. All the giants give the oath. She went down to Earth and got every human to give the oath, every animal on Earth to give the oath. Then she went to every tree, every bush, every stone. She went to metal, she went to water, she went to fire. Everything she made gave an oath that they would never, ever do anything to hurt Baldar. So she went back and says, "Right, everything has sworn that they will never do anything to hurt you." And with that, she drew a knife and stabbed him in the chest, and the knife felt a bit before it hit Baldar. She says, "I told you, nothing can hurt you." So he went out and he says, "Odin, nothing can hurt us. Draw your sword, strike us, nothing can hurt us." Odin drew sword, struck him. Sword just disappeared. Couldn't hurt Baldar, because of all metals that give the oath never to hurt Baldar. So everyone's out celebrating. Sorry, I had to turn it off there. There was people coming past. No. So everyone had promised that they wouldn't hurt Baldar. And all the gods were celebrating. And everyone went to the main courtyard, Asgard. And they were all having turns, each throwing stones at him and shooting arrows at him. And all shouting and shouting because nothing could hurt Baldar. And Hodor, Baldur's brother, who was blind, starts saying, "What's happening? What's happening? Why is everyone cheering? Why is everyone shouting?" And he says, "Well, it's because Baldar will not die. Everything's sworn that it won't hurt him. So all the weapons just turn to dust. You can try and hit them with a tree trunk and they'll just collapse. You can try and burn and the flames will just die. Nothing can hurt them." And Hodor says, "It's brilliant. I wish I could be part of this." Now, Loki was sitting close and he heard this. And he had a plan. He changed himself into an old woman and went to see Frigga. He says, "Frigga," he says, "it's so good." Well, she says, because she's an old woman, "Frigga, it's so good. Nothing can hurt Baldar. How did you get everything not to give an oath not to hurt Baldar?" She goes, "I just asked them." He says, "You asked everybody, every tree, every fruit, every man, every woman, every god." She says, "Well, except for mistletoe, which is just a silly little branch. Mistletoe is the only thing I didn't have give an oath, because, well, mistletoe is nothing." So the old lady left. And here was Loki's plan. He went off, got some mistletoe, made a dart out of the mistletoe. Then he went back into the crowd. Now, because everyone had given an oath not to hurt Baldar, including Loki, he couldn't do anything. And Hodor was standing, cheering, and he says, "Oh, I wish I could take part in this." And Loki went up and says, "Well, you can.
He says, well, how can I? I've got no swords or nothing to hit him with. He says, here's a dart. I'll point you in the right direction. And you just throw the dart at him and he'll disappear. So when I got the dart, Loki faced him towards Baldur. And he threw the dart and hit Baldur. And immediately Baldur collapsed dead. So Hoda started chanting, and then everyone else stopped. He says, what's happened? What's happened? And someone shouts, you've killed Baldur. He says, but Baldur can't die. Baldur can't die. The mistletoe hadn't given its oath. So the mistletoe didn't know anything. So when it pierced Baldur's skin, it killed him immediately. That's the story of how Baldur got killed. Now, he went to Helheim, and Odin went down to try and retrieve him from Helheim. And Hel says, I can't just give him up. If every living creature on Earth says they want him back, I'll return him. So Odin says, right, I'll get every living creature. So he went back up to Asgard and he sent out messengers, go and ask every living creature, every person, every god, every troll, every giant, that if they all agree, we can have Baldur back. So all these envoys went out and asked every person they could find. And of course, every person had been crying since Baldur died. So they all said, yeah, we want him back, we want him back, we want him back. They went to a cave, and in that cave was Loki, who again disguised himself as a woman. And Odin's envoy went in there and says, oh, we've come to ask you if you want to have Baldur back, because if everyone agrees, he can come back. And the old lady, Loki, says, no, I don't like him. Never liked him. And the guy says, do you realise what'll happen if you say you don't like him? He says, yeah, I don't like him. So the envoy went back to Odin and says, Odin, there's an old lady living in a cave. She doesn't want Baldur back. And that's why Baldur couldn't return. There's more to that story. And it is a good story. But I'll leave it up to you to have a look at that. To look it up. To see what happens next. It's a very interesting story. Very powerful story. Treachery. Betrayal, vengeance, justice. Okay, everyone. That's it for me from now. Heal the gods. Heal Odin. Heal Tyr. Heal Aya. Heal Baldur. Stay safe, everyone. Toodles.